Shankar, Lada, in case the vendor happens to see the amount, will he return it? Gayatri, Lada, no, you are very innocent. That vendor seemed to be a poor. We cannot expect sincerity and truth in poet. Madam, madam, her voice is here. What Gayatri am totally upset. At this crucial moment, she is going to ask a loan. Sharikar, what loan? Gayatri, Gayatri's daughter wants to go for an educational tour. So, she asked me a loan of 500, never gave her a single pie. Again she has come for the same purpose. Gayatri, Lada, enters, madam, here is 25,000, please count and check. Gayatri, Gayatri, how did you get this amount? Madam, the vessel vendor is none other than my husband. Since fused to wash all your clothes, I could identify sir's old dresses. I checked with my husband where he bought them from. While I was casually checking the pockets, I was shocked to see this amount kept in his pants pocket. I became restless. My husband told me to go immediately to return this money to you. That is why I came now. Shankar, Lada, I am really inspired to see the sincerity of Gayatri and her husband. Though you did not give her 7,500, she asked for, she has come back without any hesitation to return such a huge amount. She is really great. Lada, yes? I am very sorry, I regret for what I said about the poor. I have learned a lesson. Now I understand the noble character of the poor people. Please give me 1,000. Shankar gives 1,000 to Lada and she gives it to Gayatri. Gayatri, no need, madam. Today my husband had a good income. He himself gave T500 to my daughter. Okay. Madam, it is time up. I go home. Lada, Gayatri, I feel very sorry for my prejudice. Please forgive me. Gayatri, it's okay, madam. I am happy that now you have understood the attitude of the poor. That is enough for me. Tomorrow I will be on time. Lada, goodbye, Gayatri. We are ready to discard our old clothes, torn and worn out slippers. We are not hesitating to put the waste in the dustbin. But, are we ready to change our opinion about others, without knowing them completely? Do we make prejudgment about others without proper information? Examples. Thinking the thin peoples are always active. Fat peoples are always inactive. His face shows that he cannot study well. Surely, he could have stolen the things from the jewelry. Because, there is a proverb, face is the index of mind. His appearance shows that he should be the murderer. Thinking about a person negatively and making prejudgment is against human rights. This is what we call violation of human rights. We should be ready to weed out our prejudices and prejudgments about others.